Although DJ Head took a strong stance in the Kendrick Lamar and Drake feud by playing at the pop-out, he has more to say about the Toronto superstar than just criticism. Welcome back, it's your host Nancy Brown. If you are new here, make sure you have subscribed to our YouTube channel. Additionally, he just showed him some respect on HipHopDX's Elliott Wilson-hosted podcast, The Bigger Picture.
Thank you, Drake, what you've done for the ecosystem. We appreciate you. No, I'm not even throwing shade.
The Akademiks TV caption for this clip is largely pro-Drizzy and anti-K-Dot, which makes sense considering Akademiks' ongoing spat with Head.
Drake has done more for hip-hop than a lot of people give him credit for.
Nevertheless, despite the impression that Kendrick created with his diss tracks, the California native believes that the boy deserves a great deal of recognition for his contributions to hip-hop.
Because he's actively participated in the culture the whole time.
DJ Head's remarks began on The Bigger Picture.
There's credit to be owed for that. He's also used his platform to benefit others outside of himself.
He concluded, with Jeremy Hecht asserting that he has a family tree. Drake appears to be attempting to demonstrate this with his 100 gigs content drops, which highlight his involvement in the rap industry for more than 10 years. Though we're not precisely sure what this game would entail, his aggressive new music suggests that he wants to play game 2 with Kendrick Lamar. Will their upcoming albums be a sales war or just another lyrical back and forth? Will they truly fight one another once more, or does Aubrey want to concentrate on winning the long game and maintaining his position as the best in the business? In response to Akademiks' recent allegations that Kendrick Lamar is about to release a new album, DJ Head addressed the claims in the most recent episode of The Bigger Picture. For the show, DJ Head had posted a straightforward baseball cap emoji on X in response to Ak's forecast from earlier this month. He then sent out another mysterious message, "Dot don't really talk to nobody, especially not Ak." The man himself responded to the latter tweet, which many took to be a jab at Akademiks. It sounded like he thought DJ Head was criticizing his recent forecast of a new Kendrick Lamar album. "DJ Head, I'm the greatest single journalist you've ever heard of," Ak said during a livestream. "I built a 20-plus year industry by doing this shit. I played Drake's video and Drake had to ask me, how'd you get it?" Elliott Wilson, the editorial director of hip-hop journalism at DX's parent company, Uproxx Studios, joked that Head got ethered by Akademiks in the most recent episode of The Bigger Picture, which aired on Saturday, August 31st. Wilson then questioned, "Is Kendrick coming out with an album anytime soon?" DJ Head's response was not right now, though he did note Akademiks has sources. Head used the chance to politely address the situation, raising concerns about the accountability and role of media personalities such as Akademiks. He questioned the panelists on whether they thought Akademiks was the best journalist working today. Head, Wilson, and Jeremy Hecht of HipHopDX declined the invitation. Though Head agreed that Akademiks had succeeded in amassing millions of followers on a sizable platform, he questioned whether this alone made Ak the greatest in the industry. The West Coaster clarified that he regards his role as a journalist with great seriousness. In addition to being a fantastic musician, Kendrick Lamar is also a family man, an entrepreneur, and a true anime villain who presumably wags his tail when his plot to rule the world proceeds exactly as expected. Many admirers came to this final conclusion during his historic struggle with Drake, and even his cousin Baby Keem concurs. Additionally, the affiliate of PG Lang forwarded a widely shared joke on Twitter regarding K-Dot, which goes, "Kendrick the type of Anna to disappear after the bus passes." While it's amusing to consider that Kendrick saw all the memes centered around his feud with Drizzy, it's even more absurd to consider Keem's involvement and trolling of online communities. Moreover, this marks the first interaction between Baby Keem and Kendrick Lamar that the public has seen since possibly their combined Vegas show in February. However, this does not negate the fact that the Melodic Blue creative's name was mentioned during the 2024 Great Rap War. For instance, at this time, a Kendrick-referenced song for Keem's Bullies made a reappearance, adding to the lengthy discussion that Drake fans were already having at the time on ghostwriters and protégés. But a reference track doesn't always mean a lyrical ghostwriter, thus perhaps the boy has received unfair criticism for referencing Lil Yachty, Party Next Door, and other artists. Nevertheless, there's a lot of disagreement about whether utilizing other artists' cadences or consensually, and promptingly drawing inspiration from them is equivalent to stealing their songs. In any case, trying to hold people to a double standard just serves to cloud the conversation, as Kendrick Lamar and Baby Keem may have demonstrated lately through a leak that writing for other people is a very frequent practice. Furthermore, a new purported reference track featuring Kendrick Lamar covering Baby Keem's 2019 song Bullies from Die For My BH has appeared online. However, there is no concrete proof of whether or not this is actually AI. Who composed what, etc., you may judge for yourself, but it seems very legitimate compared to other purportedly bogus leaks. It's also interesting to watch how Keem's mixtape came to be. It's also known that they have previously worked together on a number of songs, so the supposed leak isn't all that shocking. Moreover, Kendrick Lamar just made more leaks that came to light just before he answered to Drake with Euphoria. It's not a direct comparison, though, as these included previously unheard songs and additional unreleased material. Even so, opinions on how to see, understand, and evaluate writers use vary widely. Does it matter if you're a famous artist or the type of song you make? Or is it just relevant when you make bold claims like Drizzy?